insights from the world's best medical minds. You are watching TheRightDoctors.com.
There are lots of questions regarding whether pregnant women are at higher risk for the COVID-19 infection or not. So I would like to say there is not much information available on how the new coronavirus affects pregnancies. At present, there is also no evidence that they are at higher risk of severe illness than the general population. However, due to physiological changes in their body and in their immune system, we know that pregnant women can be badly affected by some other similar respiratory infections. I think logically it makes sense that a pregnant woman would be at higher risk of complications from the virus than a non-pregnant one, but it is not proven at present. Pregnant women who have other comorbid health status like gestational diabetes mellitus, hypertension, obesity or respiratory problems, they need to be extra vigilant. So it is therefore important for them to take strict precautions to protect themselves against COVID-19 and report immediately when they have possible symptoms like fever, cough, difficult breathing or any other to their obstetricians. Research is still going on and WHO will guide us about the and update us about the information. Another important thing is then strict precautions means what they should do. So basically same precautions should be taken when she is not pregnant, like a non-pregnancy state. They can protect themselves by washing their hands frequently and properly with soap and water or an alcohol-based hand rub for minimum 20 seconds, by keeping space of minimum 1 meter while communicating with others. At home also they should keep a distance of 1 meter, avoiding touching their eyes, nose and mouth. They should practice respiratory hygiene, means they should cover their mouth and nose with their bent elbow, handkerchief or tissue while coughing or sneezing, and then the used tissue should be disposed properly and immediately. If they have fever, cough or difficulty in breathing, they should immediately seek medical care and they should call to a health facility before going, so that they should follow the direction of given by the local health authority to whom they are approaching. They should also take good nutritious food to build up their immunity. And pregnant women affected by COVID-19 and who have recently delivered should attend their routine care as per the schedule, as per the advice, as per the appointment given by the obstetrician. Another important thing, question or worry is, always there is a question or worry that can it affect the fetus. So primary research suggests that it is not likely to be transmitted from a mother to her baby through the womb. As per the two reports, including 18 cases published in China, there was no transmission of the virus in the mother's amniotic fluid, cord blood or breast milk, and all the newborns who were delivered via cesarean sections tested negative for the coronavirus. However, two cases of neonatal infections have been documented in one case. The diagnosis was made at day of 17 of the life after close contact with the infant's mother, and a maternity matron, both were infected in that case with the virus. And in other case, it was diagnosed 36 hours after birth. It is not clear it was transmitted across the placenta or it was through the mother, or it was infant got the virus shortly after the birth from the mother. So there is no convincing evidence that coronavirus infection can affect fetal growth in utero, but other similar viruses have been in past shown to cause fetal growth restrictions, and therefore an extra sonography scan 14 days later is advisable as a precaution in pregnant women having confirmed coronavirus infection. One more query or worry is whether they should always be undergo cesarean section. So answer is no, because the WHO and there is no other guideline advice that cesarean section should only be it's required, and it should be performed only when it is medically required. So the obstetrician will decide whether in that particular case cesarean section is required or not. There is currently no evidence to consider a cesarean birth to be safer than vaginal birth. However, if a respiratory condition, we know that in this virus, there can be a respiratory problems, and if a respiratory condition like breathing or any other condition or any other problem suggests that urgent delivery is needed, a cesarean birth may be considered by an obstetrician and may be recommended. So as for the WHO at present, the mode of delivery should be individualized and based on obstetric indications, medical reasons and a women's preference after proper counseling. And I think last important question we should address is, again the query is regarding the breastfeeding. The new coronavirus is also not found in the breast milk of mothers with confirmed COVID-19 or under investigations when patient is under investigation. As breast milk is the base source of nutrition and immunity, we all know that it is a base source for the nutrition and immunity for the infant. So it is always encouraged by the WHO. But there are different guidelines, different recommendations by some other colleges that they should be separated. But otherwise, on more, most of the recommendations are in favor and they are encouraging breastfeeding. Women with COVID-19 can breastfeed if they wish to do so. Mother should practice. Only thing is they should also, here also, they should take some extra precautions. We can say strict precautions to save the baby from the transmission of the COVID-19 infection. Mother should practice respiratory hygiene by wearing a mask and not sneezing in front of a baby during feeding. Pregnant woman should wash her hands before and after touching the baby. All surfaces should be kept clean and disinfect they have touched. A mother with confirmed COVID-19 infection or who is asymptomatic, if expressing breast milk with a manual or electric breast pump, the mother should wash her hands before touching any pump or bottle parts and follow recommendation for proper pump cleaning after each use. If she is too unwell to breastfeed her baby due to COVID-19 infection or other complications, she can be supported to safely provide her baby with breast milk by expressing the milk or any other way. But it is a prevent. So breastfeeding is not that much. Most of the recommendations are in favor of the breastfeeding. But if yes, doctor or neonatologist thinks it is better to separate, then as per the advice or as per the situation, they can decide. But otherwise, the guidelines or most of the recommendations with the proper precautions, if patient is can take the proper precautions to prevent the transmission, they can give the breastfeeding. So at the end, I would like to say we should not become much panic, but we should know that it's preventable, and there should not it is a preventable by self-discipline, by following strict and preventable precautions, and when they should follow the precautions, and when they have the any symptoms, they should immediately report to the obstetricians, and if by chance they are in labor or cesarean section or any operation is decided for the patient or her fetus, then the during labor and during operation theater, personal protective equipment and separate dedicated labor room and operation theater are required to prevent the transmission to healthcare providers and the baby. So care should be exerted, and mother should exert the proper care, and healthcare providers should guide them for the breastfeeding with proper care to prevent the transmission of a baby. I think if we follow this, then there is no other report to threaten a pregnant woman. They should not be so much afraid. Of course, proper precaution, proper preventable measures, immediate reporting to the doctor and immediate care is required. And they require a quality care. For quality, and sometimes they also require a critical care. So there are also not, this is just suggestion and a very small trial, and it is not any guideline, or there is no recommendation of WHO or SCOG or RCOG or even FOGSI or Government of India. So it's difficult to say at present, but Of course, when patient is having malaria and if she requires chloroquine, then with proper counseling, with certain care, certain medicines, we have to take in the we have to look at the balance of the interest of both mother and fetus, and sometimes we have to give some medicines. But if it is genuinely required, or otherwise in such cases, it just by suspecting or just by thinking just for the prevention, it should not be at present recommended. But after all, look, at present situation is more important, and doctor will decide whether it should be given or not in that particular case. If she is critical, if she is having serious complications, then doctor may think on it. But just for prevention, at present, I don't think there is a recommendation of in favor of. Tomorrow, there can be more studies. We may have some data and then we can talk on it. Thank you very much.
Insights from the world's best medical minds. You are watching TheRightDoctors.com.